Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting Adobe Illustrator tutorial. And in this tutorial we are going to talk about the fill and stroke and the difference between fill and stroke and what they are. Okay, to put it in simple terms, whatever inside is inside your shape, okay, it is called the fill. It's like the jug or a glass, that whatever inside it is the fill, the water or the, you know, lemonade or whatever you want to drink. And the outer wall of the jug or the glass, it is called the stroke. And this bounding box, the line that surrounds this yellow area, it's called the stroke. Now I increase the size of the stroke to 10 part. Usually on default it's 1, so it might be thin, you might not see it clearly if it's on default videos, but to make the point clearer, I increase its size, of course, once you have to select it, to 10. So now the color, as you can see, it's blue color, it's light red, and this is green and it's yellow color. Now whenever people want to affect one color or of the fill, or they want to affect the color or change the color of the stroke, they have difficulty selecting these things. You know, sometimes when people do not know the difference between them, they said, okay, they might want to modify only the color of the stroke, but it modifies the color of the fill, or we want to modify the fill and the stroke does not get modified, or we want to modify them both, it to be both look the same color, or we just want to remove the stroke. So how to achieve these things? You know, once you have selected your object, as you can see here, okay, then if you go to swatches or your color guide or whatever way that you want to change your colors, for example, now you want to change this from, you know, like yellow to, okay, green or red or something, it's affecting the fill, it's not affecting the stroke. The stroke is still remaining the same blue color. Why is that? Why can't we change the stroke? Well, because for it to be affected or its color to be changed, it has to be brought in front. Although they both are on the same level as layers are concerned, but they are not. Look at these two boxes, squares. The first one is the fill and the second one is the stroke. To change them or bring forth one of them, you know, to be affected by colors or changes or alterations, you have to click on it, then it brought it in front. Now stroke is in front. Now whatever change we make in here is not going to affect the, okay, first of all we need to select the object. Now when I select new colors, it's affecting our stroke, not our fill, like that, as you can see. Now to change it back, we have to select the fill and bring it forward. The keyboard shortcut for doing this working back and forth between stroke and fill is X. As you can see, when you click it on the keyboard, it brings it to the front and sends it backward. If you click on this small icon next to fill and stroke, what it does is that it swaps the fill and stroke colors. Now look at it, this color will be swapped. Okay, first of all, you have to always select the object. As we have learned before, it has to be selected to be affected. Okay, as you can see, the fill and the stroke colors change. It become red, it become blue, and again it became red and it become blue. This color, the shortcut for it is D. If you click on it, it's going to return back to default color. Default colors are white and black. Okay, like this. And its size is also returned to default values, which of course we did not want it to be. We want it to be a 10. Like, okay, first of all, select. I think they made that mistake like about 10 times in this tutorial alone. Okay, so the other thing besides this, these three icons down here, you need to understand fill and stroke clearly. The first one is for the stroke, for the color. It means that there will be a stroke and color applied to it if you know your fill or whatever is in front of it. The second one applies a gradient to it. Gradient is, let's say that it's a type of color, a gradual transformation between two colors, like white and black. In this case, it could be red and blue or gray or something. It is not, half of the part is given to green and red, you know, it gradually starts and all the shades and the tones and the tints of one color gradually transform into the other color. Like from total white, it transforms slowly, gradually to total black. And yeah, we are going to talk about gradient in the upcoming tutorial. And I'm gonna teach you all these parameters, what they do and how to apply them and make your, you know, project look good. But you don't need to talk about that much in detail in this tutorial. Okay, the third button is of none. When you click it, this place becomes empty. So you are saying, okay, it's still white. It's not white because the background is white. If I bring it here, you can see the place is empty. And if I click on this place color, then it gives it color. And let us select a green color. You can see this removes it, this brings it back. And if I bring my stroke in front, then the stroke gets out and it comes back when you select it. Of course, you can apply the gradient. Of course, once you change, alter it and bring back the stroke, then its size becomes smaller. You can apply the gradient to stroke also. As you can see, stroke is being only applied to the gradient, and many beautiful shapes can be created this way. And the bottom of these layers are, you know, for bringing something forward. It's for an arrangement, you know. If this one is in a background, the selected one, and the other way in front, you can click this one and it's going to bring it to forward. Okay, let me click it. Okay, it's not bringing or doing whatever we wanted it to do. Okay, so arrangement can be done from here also. Send it forward, as you can see, like that. But this button also did the same thing, but it's not doing it. Okay, so with that said, this concludes our tutorial about the differentiation between stroke and fill. And now I think you have a firm grasp of what fill and stroke is and how to individually affect them if needs be, and how to alter them or delete them even if you don't want the fill or don't want the stroke to be applied to your shape. So in the next tutorial, we will be talking about gradient in more detail, which is this thing in this window. So, with that said, I take my leave from you guys.